We're here with the cast of AK Wonder versus Just Saiyan. I'm here with Xixo. Say hi.
Hey.
Okay, here we go. So we are ready. Players are ready, it seems. So we're just waiting for them. But in the meantime, we can talk about the lineups, I guess. AK Wonder, we've seen them both on stream because it's the losers match. So we have Druid Mage Warlock for AK Wonder, and Just Saiyan has Druid Shaman Warrior. And Warlock and Warrior are banned each. So pretty common lineups, kinda, or?
Yeah, I mean, Mage isn't that common from AK Wonder, but you don't really expect common decks from AK Wonder anyway.
Maybe a cartoon or two. So hopefully they will start now.
This is a loser's match, the winner match was purple against Ignite. Ignite took that one, so whoever wins this match has to play against purple in the deciders.
Okay, I see they've just started, so we are joining the game now. Who do you think is favored in this matchup?
Mage against Shaman. Let's see if it's freeze or tempo. Okay, it looks like tempo mage. People have, like, Adio says it's 70% for tempo mage. I think it's slightly favored for Shaman, but it's a pretty even matchup. Oh, wait, that's not the Shaman I was expecting.
No,
I don't know how Conceit Shaman does against it. It's not a matchup I have tested.
No, you didn't. Why?
Yeah, I'm slacking.
Okay, but I think, like, the Shaman should be, like, favored, right?
I don't know. I think that Tempo Mage is pretty good against Freeze Mage, which kind of should play out similar, because, like, you have a lot of burst.
Yeah, but you have a lot of heal as well, huh?
Yeah, but I mean, you don't really want to heal from, like, 20 HP, but if they have a couple of minions out, they can burst that. We'll see how it goes, but I don't know.
Okay, Farsight. Just hero power, easy turn. Kalsa Astra.
Yeah, I mean, AK Wonder is basically just searching for an apprentice, so you can, like, Flamebreaker apprentice coin and do all that cheating stuff.
All that beautiful cheating stuff.
Yeah, just saying, doesn't play the mana type because just gets traded in by the 3-2, so plays Farsight.
Just a Doomsayer for free.
Yeah. Yeah, you have to play the Doomsayer here, like, what else would you save it for? I guess you could save it for an AoE turn to play it together with, like, a Lightning Storm, but I would expect it to be played here.
Yeah, especially because, like, yeah, what can you do against Tempo Mage? Taking Tempo with a Tempo Doomsayer, right?
Nah. Yeah, you don't want to take, like, 3 to 5 damage every turn just from board. Like, you want to control the board so all the damage has to be spells.
Yeah. And if something goes wrong, you still got Elemental Destruction here.
Yeah, I mean, if Doomsayer gets killed, it would get killed at any point. Might as well just do it now. So you can either Frostbolt and trade it, or Arcane Intellect and just let it die, unless he draws an Arcane Blast of the Intellect, but he doesn't want to risk it.
Completely understandable, in my opinion.
Yeah, it's like, you know it's Conceit Charm, and you know there's no Flame Tongue, so the 3-2 is decent on board.
Ooh. So, second Farsight. Only picking up second Lava Shop. Shock off.
Yeah, but it's pretty good because you can play, like, Earth Elemental and zero mana Lava Shock.
Yeah.
As you can play.
On curve.
Or you save it. I guess you don't really have to play it because you still have mana to play the 2 mana Lava Shock. And.
Yeah, you can still start your turn with that.
Yeah, so you probably want to keep the 0 mana Flame Shock to combo it with Elemental Destruction.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty decent. So, card draw.
So, yeah, I'm pretty sure we will see the Earth Elemental and Zero Mana Lava Shock here just because you want to kill the 3-2 and you want to develop a 7-8. It's a 7-8, right?
Again, I was just disturbed by the noise. I don't know where it came from. Okay. That was like 3 damage.
Okay, so probably. If he has a 1 mana spell, he'll go for the Flamebreaker here, but since he doesn't, I don't know, he might just see Azure Track pass, honestly.
Mm.
sets up for a somewhat decent flame strike if the trade happens.
Perhaps.
And 4 damage should be pretty tough to deal, even with spell damage for the shaman. I don't think there's lightning bolts in the deck.
Who's the other guy? Noxix. So yeah, it's me. I'm Camlan.
With the 4.
Yeah, with the 4, because I ran out of ace.
Interesting.
Do you know that, like, you can press every key on your keyboard more than one time?
Yeah, I found out when I hit the N. But it was already too late.
It's unlucky.
Yeah, unlucky. Sometimes unlucky. So, okay, he's going for the Flamewaker turn here.
So, Flamewaker, first world pass, Ayush. I guess it adds another power flame strike. Yeah, probably better play.
Yeah. Yeah, that's somewhat
decent.
Yeah, somewhat decent. Okay. Oh, Buck Creeper. Ancestral knowledge, drawing.
Oh, that's a pretty good.
That's nice.
Yeah, you play that and the. What's the name?
Hmm?
Stormquake.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So. GG!
Yeah, it's that was like the perfect combination of two top decks, or?
Pretty good. Yeah. Like, you have 4 mana left. 4 mana, get a 2 mana removal for Flamewaker and a 2 mana 7-8.
I might win you the game, maybe.
I think I would play a 2 mana 7-8 in my deck.
Yeah, I think I would fit in 2 or 3 of them, if it's possible. Okay, Mana Worm. Okay, only 4 mana left. Oh, shock. Faceless Manipulator.
I mean,
here we go.
Sure, I'm supposed to make the game exciting, but we see 3 Earth Elementals on board since the 1 respawns.
So much Earth and Elemental on board.
I don't think we will see someone else in the Shaman winning this game.
Yeah, he's still like at 26 HP. How do you win from here on? Disconnecting, maybe?
Honestly, I don't think AK Wonder would take the regame. I think AK Wonder would instantly offer just saying to just take the win if there was a disconnect here. I think AK Wonder is
a
pretty fair player. And
yeah, sure, of course he is. That wasn't... So, Blood Mage.
Oh, he doesn't coin the Kalt Sorcerer, instead coins the ping.
Yeah, it's 7 damage less on the board, but...
Yeah, but I mean, he could have done the same and played the Apprentice. Like, he had the choice to play the 3-2.
So,
I don't really know why he didn't. He saw both Flamestrikes already, so...
Yeah, but he's aiming for the Flamestrike next turn. So, only the Flamestrike. So
does the 3-2 hurt your Flamestrike turn?
Yeah, but it would die because he can trade, basically. But, yeah...
So, you can trade a 7-4 into it, and even then you can trade your... Thalnos into the 7-1 and damage the new Earth Elemental. So, Flamestrike missiles. I don't think you want to leave up a 5-1 if you don't have to. Actually, the right play here is Rag and just hit the 5-5. Works every time.
Play it first, or. Like all the matters. Oh, yeah! The last one.
So if he top decks the fireball, he actually can clear the board. Actually, no.
And suddenly there's only 1 Earth Elemental left, but yeah, quickly joined by
the... So all the Tempo Storm guys are playing this Conceit Shaman with Borg Creeper.
Yeah, but Frodin said he just asked Zion.
Yeah, but Zion was saying off, like, in the players area that he gave Frodin the list but didn't ping it himself. So he was mind gaming.
That's
pretty sick. So Rag's gonna kill the 0-2 totem, AK1 is gonna
quiet. Oh no! Why?
Called it.
Yeah, you're not only good at hunting Pokemons, I guess. No comment.
Yeah, I mean, that's a very good RNG roller. I can predict all those random outcomes.
That explains a lot.
My father owns Blizzard.
That was impressive, yeah. I fought for it for like 2 minutes. Okay, so you're at 10 health. You have a huge frog as a taunt between you and all the small guys on the other side.
Yeah, you might as fireball yourself here.
Yeah. Yeah, but still it's not enough. Feels bad. Azudrek fireball will do the job like a little bit better.
No. What can you top deck like?
Maybe some kind of freeze effect.
I think it's a top deck a Doomhammer somehow. So maybe they're playing wild, you can Azudrek into Plinktron to get Doomhammer and double face tank so you die.
Doomhammer?
Yeah. Plinktron into Doomhammer so you can double face tank.
Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ah, okay. You're still on the Sudoku path.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah, yeah, okay.
What else is there? We're not winning this game.
Okay, so, but maybe we can think about that.
I mean, Stormquake is lethal. Actually, yeah, that's a better lethal. I like that. Stormcrack is blowing.
Stormcrack?
Stormcrack onto the totem would have been enough.
Yeah.
This is better.
Yeah, it just doesn't matter, but what do you queue into the Conceit Shaman now?
He has Druid and... No, he has... Yeah, Druid and...
Warlock.
Warlock. I mean, it has to be the Druid.
Yeah, if it's Zulok, it has to be the Druid, because...
I mean, it's always Zulok. Let's be... I mean, Kaivanda is kind of known for playing Kassoon, Reno Lock, but... Yeah, even then you play the Druid.
No faith in Cartoon?
No, I have faith in Yogg. But it's okay, Wonders, we'll probably see Yogg Druid anyway. And, we don't see it yet, which Druid it is. But it has to be the Claw, which indicates Kassoon.
Yeah, I'm not sure. We've seen like some Yogg token Druids.
Yeah, it indicates. Didn't say it has to be.
For me, it's token. It indicates
nice
that
call.
That's token.
Crystal Kassoon, so like I've played all those list, all those four cards in my Kassoon Druid I played at the last stream hack, so could still be Kassoon, but we will see. Pretty bad hand from just saying so far. Okay. Could still be Kassoon.
Yeah, you want to carry on with that? Okay, Living Roots from the Token Druid.
Are you sure?
Say it. Okay, just some random heal totem. And yeah.
So we Raven Idol here so we can form minion to get Kassoon?
Buff Kassoon with the Raven Idol Kassoon minion. But yeah, the healing totem perfectly fits his hand. Some heal here.
Yeah, so they need it.
It's the theme of this game now.
Yeah, so I guess AK1 has to Raven Idol into Healing Wave to match that somewhat.
Yeah, so it's either like the Cartoon way or the Healing way or what? I don't know, I think, yeah. Just
this is like, of course it's a Heal Druid. Like, why would you play Raven Idol if you don't play Heal Druid?
Yeah, that's a good point, actually.
Does not develop anything which will make it harder for him to remove the mana type, because if he wants to just remove it, he has to use the hero power, which he really doesn't want to. He wants to develop a teacher.
Yeah, especially not turn 3.
Oh.
Yeah, maybe it's micro.
But do you even coin the hero power? I guess you do.
Do you want to give
him card draw, really?
Nah, I really don't want to. Okay, so he's going for the spell.
So you can naturalize the...
How many healing touches
you can
are
naturalize
there?
The mana type so it doesn't draw.
Yeah, that makes sense. Like, oh no, you will not draw next turn. I could pick just two cards.
Oh, see,
oh,
we saw
it. Oh, oh, oh.
He gets it.
Yeah. Would you call it a misplay?
Yeah, you should have.
Yeah, nah.
Played that.
Okay, but he clears here, keeping Wildcrow in his hand. So, Earth Elemental. Yeah, that's kind of a dead turn, right? Do you want to draw here? But then, what do you do next turn?
I mean, the 7-8 is really bad if you can't combo it, like... But...
And another healing totem! He stays in line with the healing theme.
Yeah. So, buy the teacher into Korean Emperor? Actually... I really like being the teacher here. Like, if it was me, I probably would go to teacher into nourish to draw, and then like get emperor on a million cards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, makes sense. And I think you win via outvaluing your opponent, not out tempoing.
Yeah, I mean you have to go tempo, you have to go for tempo, but not now. You can go for tempo like 2 turns later.
Yeah.
But you're not gonna fatigue the shaman with like 6 fire elementals in his deck.
Earth elementals.
Oh, yeah.
But okay, I got your point. And
yeah, come on, it's like pretty late.
Yeah, it is actually. It's 9 a.m. What the? Okay, never mind. So that's the first Earth Elemental.
So, but we have to naturalize. I really like nourish for card draw here and then naturalize.
Mm-hmm.
I think I saw the Emperor instead.
Emperor coin naturalize.
It is more tempo, but I really like getting more cards reduced.
Maybe it's fine because.
Yeah, I mean, it's fine for sure, but you save the coin and you get more cards reduced. You lose some tempo, but you get the tempo back since you save 3 mana next turn.
Mm-hmm. And, how will he clear it now?
Oh, yeah, I guess it's not that easy for the Charm to remove the 5/5.
There it is. Maybe.
Yeah, but using 2 cards and 5 mana to remove an Emperor and 2/1/1s.
Yeah, and they look so cute.
Actually, he can't even do it because he's overloaded, so you would have to play Lava Shock first to guarantee killing the Emperor.
Yeah.
You don't want Lava Shock and then.
It's not worth.
Yeah.
Killing too cute.
I mean, now you just teach and draw cards. Oh, wait, no, you have to. So I guess you. I think you're nervous and rest, but you could go for Azor Track. Rest, but yeah, I like drawing cards.
Hmm.
That's pretty good.
Okay. Another Raven Idol.
Yeah, so you just rest, Power of the Wild to buff your minions, spread a 2/2 in, go face for 8 damage.
Hmm. Yeah.
I just like the going face part.
the end of your turn. Oh, ship. He's not buffing, he's just keeping it for the Violet Teacher turn. Like, not.
6/6 can't die to the AoE alone. It's more damage.
Yeah, but if he AoEs this board, you're completely fine, right?
Yeah, but I mean.
Because you always want to.
6/6 also doesn't die to, like, spell damage, Stormcrack.
Yeah.
And I feel like you already have so much value in your hand, you don't need to be greedy with the Power of the Wild, but we'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
Faces an Emperor in order to set up his combos. He could have went for the Earth Elemental and Ancestral Knowledge there. No, what's it called? Ancestral Spirit? I think so.
No knowledge.
I mean the spirit.
Ancestral.
You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know.
So you could have went for the double fire elemental.
Okay,
but
swipe.
It shows not to.
Drake swipe. Yeah, into pushing phase. He's pushing quite some damage now.
Wait.
I do. Nah.
Yeah, you can't do it. Yeah, even if it's silly, the correct play, you just can't do it.
No.
Because you would, like, you would kind of look silly.
Yeah, it was like. Do I really want to confirm the misplay here? Nah, I don't.
I don't like it. He kept the Raven Idol. Like, it gives him another 1/1 with a teacher, but he could get the card he gets reduced, so he would save a mana by playing it now. So
mm-hmm.
I would like just playing the Raven Idol there, going for any kind of burst spell.
Yeah, and next turn you go anyways, like 3 spells for 0 mana into York, into Easy Lethal.
Yeah, you can Wild Wars on turn 10 for 0 mana, so that's 2 more spells for York. Then you play York.
Okay. Earth Elemental, Ancestor Spirit. Now finally he clears it, but oh! Hello there!
Yeah, I heard about that card. Don't know how that happened.
And do you like the card?
I mean, I just like winning, so no.
Hmm. Do you see his sad face now?
Yes, look at this sad face.
Thuggers the Slitherer. Yeah, I was kind of surprised because I expected, like, Gara to play it. He played it at Valencia.
Yeah, I mean.
I saw it
quite
sometimes.
But I mean, if Gara played it at Valencia, that means he already played it for a tournament, so he now knows it's bad.
Actually, his druid was having quite a good time there.
Yeah, but like other druids with Onyxia had better times.
Yeah, true.
I mean, you play it now to beat the OTK warrior because they can't deal with Sir'Goth.
Yeah.
But
and the priests.
Actually, yeah, he bans Warlock, so he wants it to beat warrior.
Yeah.
So I guess that's his reasoning. That's also why I play Sword of the Claw, just to have like a better matchup against the OTK warrior.
Hmm. But we haven't seen so many OTK warriors, right?
No, we have seen Losa playing it.
Yeah, but he said like it was a mistake to bring it because he wasn't able to practice it enough. So there's.
Did Ostkaka play it? No, wait. It
oh, no, no, wait. Froden did play. Yeah, Froden did play it. But oh no, are you sure? Because Froden like 3-0'd every time with the shaman.
Right, we saw it in that group, I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure as well, but I can't really remember.
I think it was Ostkaka.
It might be, yeah.
Yeah, it was Ostkaka.
Yeah,
then Ostkaka, he had like 29 cards drawn and needed a charge, but charge was the last card in
the
stack.
Yeah, it was the last card. So. Versus the Conceit Shaman.
Yeah, it was Froden's Conceit Shaman.
Okay, cycling. Second
gonna charge and Savage War. And Power of the Wild, do some trades, I don't know how the trades will work out, he will figure it out. He said there's mana for Wes, so...
Pretty good, I guess.
SM Orc.
And he can also play the Rast on top of it, so...
So I just said. Bible Thump.
Bible Thump. Bible Thump, Slogot. Slogot the Slytherer.
So how do you trade? You can rest and trade a 5-3 and trade a 7-5 and hero power to a 6-8. So you get face for 5 damage.
Mm.
Take 6 damage, but it's fine.
Rest your own guy? No, most likely not. Mm-hmm. Yeah. 3-3 stays on board. So
see if they play the Doomsayer here in some way. No. I guess you don't play anything else since you know, only has a 3-3. If he has this vibrant hero power to remove it, that's fine with you.
Hmm.
There's so many big minions. I mean, I would tempted to just play the Yogg here.
Nah. And then you discard your whole hand and you're set. For the rest of the day. And tomorrow. Oh, here we go. Yogg, Mortal Strike. Nope.
Never lucky.
Yogg says, nope. So, Hunter's Mark.
Not
yeah,
bad.
That's reasonable. Slam. Oh, there you go.
Face.
Oh, sick. Yeah. How do you do it?
Face.
Oh, Pyro.
I mean, one face.
Oh, okay, minion. Corruption, no target. Fist of Jyraxxus, face. South Forest, no targets. Ice block, interesting. Another 2 damage to the face.
Let's see, I want to see more damage.
Oh, Mind Blast!
I mean, he has
sick.
A lot of heal, so. Actually, he has an AoE, so it's not that much here. It's just one healing wave for now.
Yeah, yeah, but imagine the Pyro Blast had gone face here.
Yeah, it's just unlucky.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a lot of more heal since he has Hal'Azir. He doesn't play Hal'Azir yet, but it's a healing wave on turn, next one Hal'Azir and elemental destruction. Not healing at all would be too greedy, like there's no way.
Hmm?
There's no way you don't heal at all, like you have to play the healing wave, so I'm kind of surprised you didn't start with it. But I guess you want to check for the secret first.
Yeah, I guess
because
so.
If it's...
Counterspell.
If it's actually...
But test it for Counterspell.
If it's a mirror entity, you would hex whether it's the same. No, I guess the sequencing didn't really matter there, unless I'm missing something. So is it time for Mulch Innervate Sir'Goth?
Hmm? But, do you have to play Mulch?
Yeah.
I think, yeah. Swipe?
Yeah, he wants to do it next turn. So he swipes Maya Keeper, zero power.
Yeah, it's reasonable.
But Maya Keeper makes the... Hal'Azir, elemental destruction, so much better. It's like
yeah, but do you
8 to 10 heal you give to your opponent by doing it.
But do you really want to play around it?
No, probably. I mean, you will consider it, but...
Nah, it's still fine, no?
But it's this is a really weak against the Storm, so... You play that, right? You have 3 mana left, so might as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you play that and heal for a lot. Do you use that? I think you use it. Just 2 mana... I mean, 3 mana basically because you've played the... Far side, so 3 mana, 4-6.
Hmm.
I think you just use it because if you don't get a minion, you just set. And the 4-6 is the, it's not a Earth Elemental, but you use those anyway, so you.
And he can just heal up forever.
It's like he has 1-6-8 Tauntlet, I think, but it's the only big minion, right? I mean, I don't know his deck list exactly, but I feel like you probably should just use it here, get a 4-6 back. I'd be happy with it.
Yeah. And that's what he does.
But that Sargoth is gonna be huge.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Do you...
I kinda you like Teacher Hero Power Mulch.
Yeah, me too.
Same.
Plus one.
You must go for the Sargoth. Oh, I'm not sure about that.
Hmm. Yeah.
Like, I probably told you that there's another like real big minion and you wouldn't have played the spell there, so I feel like you can wait a turn, but
yeah, maybe
I mean, it's a fight to just play it, I'm not hating the play.
No. I think you're fine in both ways.
Yeah, you probably win this game.
But it's hard to consider which one's the better one because they're kinda close, right? Which are the interesting decisions.
Yeah. So the other player you have a 3-5, 2-1-1s. I mean, it's easy to. He was just saying sand would be even better to just play the teacher there and wait a turn for. But not knowing that, I don't know if there's anything he plays around.
Yeah. Just uproot.
Uproot, yeah, every time.
Actually, uproot in most cases it's kind of reasonable nowadays. Not playing around BGH anymore.
Mm, yeah. So uproot is basically always correct. Because. BGH was nerfed, Black Knight wasn't nerfed.
Hmm. And it's 10 damage phase. Every turn.
Yep.
Okay, but do you mulch now? No. Yes? I think it's fine to mulch now, because your opponent just showed you that there is indeed no big minion.
Hey, yeah, what is that? That was a misclick.
Wait, it was taunt. How did that happen?
Yeah.
Misclicked. Okay. Hero pause.
Maybe you want to make it a 5-10 to play around Crazed Alchemist.
You give your opponent a chance to uproot it and it still has taunt then. Yeah, that's smart.
I mean, taunt is a downside because you want to be protected by the Sargoth taunt.
Mm. Sure.
But still,
okay. It's not that great, but it's reasonable.
I mean, it's a Fendril, it's always good.
Yeah, it's Fendril. And it has no taunt. That's the upside of in this situation. Especially in this situation.
I mean, you clear the board anyway, so you don't really care about taunt.
So, but do you mulch now, finally?
I think so.
I think finally has to. Hmm. But on the other hand, the last time I mulched, I gave powder a Tyrion.
Yeah, that's a misplay.
Yeah. I always misplay those.
Good.
Okay, hero power. Oh, there's the second Bog Creeper.
Yep.
Is it the last big minion in the stack? I guess, yeah.
I mean, the other Concealed Shamans played Enzord and they had Cairn. I'm not sure. He definitely doesn't play Enzord. I'm not sure if he still plays Cairn. So.
And some did play Maligos, but that
yeah,
was.
Yeah, he's just gonna play Maligos.
That was
but
super
he probably plays Cairn, right? Like, did we see Thorin play Cairn? I think so, but I'm not quite sure. I was focusing on my group, but I think you saw Thorin playing Cairn.
Actually, I'm not sure. I just
pretty sure they
saw the result and I was like.
Yeah. So how does it feel? The casters are doing better than you. Even Lothar just went 1-2, not 0-2?
Actually, I'm fine. Because the series I had to win was the one versus Hot Form. And there, the draw was just too different.
So, I mean, even though you drew way better, you couldn't beat him because he's a better player?
Yeah, this is basically how Hearthstone works.
Never lucky.
Yeah, sometimes lucky. I was kind of lucky in DreamHack Valencia, so I'm fine.
How far did you get there?
Top 16.
It's like $750, is it?
Or yeah, actually it is, yeah.
Sick. So you buy dinner tonight?
You've been to China recently, right?
I mean, yeah, so what?
How much did you get there? Like
with
20K?
Enough ice cream.
Okay, so splitting up the board again.
Forget the name of the card, but it's pretty sick here.
Which one?
The.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
Frostcaller.
Yeah.
And you can freeze. You can't target though, Sogoth, but you can still freeze it. If you get some decent RNG.
Mm-hmm.
And the card doesn't hit frozen targets again. It doesn't say it, but you can't hit the same target twice if there are other minions that are not frozen yet.
Mm-hmm.
What to do? I don't know how I know that because I never played the card, but I think someone told me. I don't know why anyone ever played that card, so I don't know how they figured it out, but I guess...
Playing some arena lately?
Actually, I think it was Firebird who wanted to play some bad decks. Like, he wanted to make some really bad stuff work on ladder. And end up topping from rank 16 to rank 18 while I was watching him.
Okay, so at least you know that it works like that now. Azure Drake? That's.
Yeah, you
topic.
Saw like mostly AoEs, you might as well just Azure, trade everything, play the Maya Keeper.
And the Druid has only one card. Yeah, that's the last card, and it's Innervate.
Yeah. I mean, pretty good card, Kappa.
Yeah, if you don't play it now, then never. Right?
Yeah, but never, you might make your opponent think it's something better. He plays around. Maybe he didn't notice it here.
I think he'll notice that it's like a second anywhere. It's somewhere.
Yeah.
It's so not like you can see it sometimes one off.
Yeah, but it's like when the fatigue and you focus on your combos, do you really keep track of your opponent's innervates? So we see a Cairn.
Yeah. That was the Cairn.
So
that's
right. Game, right? I think Shaman won this. I'm surprised we didn't see the Lava Shock on the 2-2 here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he was overloaded to the unlost 1 mana, so you can see the hero power afterwards. And you see your opponent out of cards. Like, I don't know. I think it's a misplay. Like, sure, you can roll spell damage, shot him and kill the 3-3 instead, but. I guess it freezes a minion, but just freezes a 1-1 most likely.
Mm-hmm.
I guess there's more to it if you consider the phase.
Yeah. And yeah, you got the second spell as well.
Yeah, use the spells first so you can hit Cairn into a minion that didn't get frozen. To lower the chances that phase gets frozen. But I guess phase getting frozen is still the same as the dude getting frozen, so it's whatever.
Yeah, right. So, both dudes getting frozen.
Yeah.
And
probably still concede here.
Yeah, and AK one draw.
This concede charm is doing work.
Yeah, conceding. Yeah, concede charm 2-0 for Justine.
6-0 for Froden.
6-0 for Froden.
Gala won some games with it. Just not that it went 2-1 in his first series, don't know how it went afterwards.
Yeah, but the version with Maligos didn't work out too well
no,
for Super
Chat. Did you see that version? Like, did you expect that deck to win?
Actually, I banned it in the second one because it was Justin Sand versus my lineup. But I'm not sure.
Yeah, but this isn't very good. You don't play two Frost Strokes in your...
Yeah, and now the downside is AK Wonder only with his Sulok. I guess it's Sulok. Yeah, we just see it here left, and you can't really win against this matchup, I guess.
I think you can. You just go face and hope they die.
Hope that there's no taunt and no heal and no AoE. Oh wait, the deck is full of all of them.
Yeah, but sometimes they just like get a couple of 7 drops in their opening hand.
Yeah, but actually that's not a couple of 7 drops, you know, that's Doomsayer. That's Elemental Destruction. And hey, there's a hex as well.
So he didn't coin Doomsayer here. I guess he wants to save a coin for turn 4 destruction coin Lava Shock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's actually reasonable. And then into Doomsayer maybe?
Or do you? No, AK1 you
just play it now. Yeah.
This like, board is super weak to just Doomsayer.
Ooh, power overwhelming.
Yeah, I mean, you have to power the well-played W1 drop, but it's still not good.
No, it's not. But then
like, still. You use two cards and two mana, just remove a two mana, one card, Doomsayer.
Yeah, but you just have to, and then you can keep going with Defender of Argus, which is kind of reasonable.
I mean, you will kind of get destroyed by the Destruction Coin Lava Shock, but... I mean, there's no other players, no way you tap and just let Doomsday go off. Like, it just doesn't work.
No.
I'm pretty sure you kill off the 1-3 and not the 2-2.
Yeah, sure.
I mean, killing off the 2-2 based on Storm a little. You can't really expect a Storm. I guess it would be unreasonable to trade the electric sacrifice.
Yeah, but you're anyhow in such a bad spot, you always go for the most risk reward play, right?
Yeah, but not really much. Yeah. What? Well. Yeah, just Argus play on curve, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
No, like. Dire Wolf tap is reasonable for sure, but.
Yeah, but still you got the Forbidden Ritual, so...
Yeah, but you saw no Storm last turn.
Oh, speaking about Storm, how do you do that, actually?
It's just... I think we just see Elemental Destruction Coin, Lava Shock Phase, and next time play 5-drop.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's a really hard time for AK Wonder here.
Yeah, his hand isn't very good against Lightning Storm.
Yeah, that's Forbidden Ritual. Crest Alchemist, too late. We already saw the Doomsayer once at least.
Mm. Yeah, it's pretty unfortunate right now. Because now it's just a dead card.
Yeah.
There's no. I mean, it's a mana tide, but still. For the next couple of turns, that will not be a good target for it, and it's just a 2-mana 2-2. You kind of cheat one set out with it, you use it with Direwolf together.
Mm.
But, yeah, I mean. This game doesn't look great for AK Wonder.
No. Especially because just still at 23 health and
maybe AK Wonder put Yogg in his deck.
Yeah, in the Zulag.
Yeah, I mean, you just need two spells. Like, you play two POs and you get two Call of the Wilds.
Two Pyroblast phase.
Works too.
Yeah. How are the odds in double Pyroblast phase while you have 5 minions on board?
I think around 50%.
Yeah, either it happens or it doesn't happen, right? Okay, Forbidden Ritual, refilling the board here. Yeah, that's
convenient,
it's a nice top deck. Thank for below, more taunt.
So.
And next turn there's even more taunt and the turn.
AK1 has a pretty good turn here. You play that over Direwolf, Crazed Alchemist? I guess you do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't really
care. So, you're just saying, doesn't draw, remove it? The game isn't over yet. This second Forbidden Ritual draw is pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just taunt.
You can deal 2 damage to it by using Crazed Alchemist on it. Mm-hmm. So it's a 6 HP. So you can trade this. All the dudes in. Oh, that's a pretty good draw.
Oh yeah, that's amazing.
Because now you can't hex the councilman and the sea giant.
Yeah, and we already saw some AoEs.
Yeah, we saw 2 of the 4 AoEs already.
Mm-hmm.
And we also AK Wonder saw that there was no more AoE in the hand, otherwise we would have AoE'd again.
Oh, why wasn't he playing?
Just BM.
Extended BM here. Already? That's pretty confident.
Yeah. Maybe I have to play this around. Just say and getting Yoxa 1 into Ice Block. Maybe you can proc him at 1 this way. So maybe just like with the mass.
I didn't follow your theory.
So, Shaman plays Yoxa 1. Gets Ice Block. And because Just saying is a 20 HP, not 12, AK1 will have a way to proc it at 1.
You lost me when you said Yogg-Saron.
The same place, Yogg-Saron.
Yeah, I like it's in his deck.
Yeah, I mean, that doesn't matter.
Yeah, it just doesn't matter.
Okay, one might expect that. Like, even he doesn't know the deck list. If it's convenient, he might as well play around it.
Ah, okay, I see. Just to be safe.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
Like, why wouldn't you play around it when you can?
Okay, powerful. Wow. That's actually.
That's Lisa.
Hmm.
In some way. I don't know which way, but.
In so many ways, I guess.
Yeah.
It's just happening?
I think it's Lisa.
Wait.
Like, yours. It's Councilman kills the one. Then you have three.
The wolf kills the other one.
You have 3, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, it's lethal. It's one over, but it's. No, it's actually exact lethal.
It's exact.
Exact lethal. I wonder. Yeah, should work. Wait. Don't wait the siege engine. It doesn't work, I don't think.
Yeah, you then just
die with position. Die with alpha. Messed up.
Trade it in, buff.
Yeah. It doesn't matter, it works. Maybe it works, I don't know. But I know that the other player was lethal, so I'm kind of worried now.
Yeah, and Imping, why didn't he play the Imp?
This is one damage off.
Yes. Wasn't it lethal?
Yeah, it was. I'm sure, like, the Councilman kills one, then your 3-3 Direwolf kill attacks into it, your 3-3 Peddler, whatever it was, and then your 2-1. Villager, that's 8 damage altogether. Then you PO your Sea Giant with a Direwolf buff. It's 13, so he had exactly so.
Yeah.
But he goes for the BM.
Again?
Sick.
It would have been lethal if he wouldn't have BM'd like before. Like extended BM'd, of course. But okay, he's getting rid of the Shaman, of the Conceit Shaman, finally. So
hey, you said it's unwinnable.
Yeah, I did.
Good.
Sometimes wrong.
Unlucky.
So there's Druid and Warrior left for just Zion.
That's a pretty good Warrior, and...
Yeah, let's go back to the game.
Warrior's hand is double Ghoul and Azotek right now. He didn't mulligan yet. I guess you only keep one Ghoul because you really want to have a 2-drop. Oh, that hand is really bad now. Avenging Ghoul, Grommash, Hellscream, and a Trachonite Crusher.
But you're getting...
You got a 2-drop, which is what you really needed, but... I think I like the Zoo hand more than the Warrior hand.
Get it out! I'm not sure what's going on in the chat. Hi, main chat.
So... This would be some sort of knife juggler. Like, he could knife juggler. He will go for the coin flips anyway, so doesn't matter if you squire or trade first. You get 2 juggles, so 75% to kill the fairy dragon. And you always go for it.
Yeah. Okay, there we go.
He goes for squire first, so if it goes face, he would consider not going for it, but I think even then he would still go for the 50-50. The light protects me. Just do it.
Go.
I think you have to. Like, it's pretty efficient as well. Like, you basically trade half of a 1-drop to have a 50-50 to kill the 2-drop.
And save your knife juggler. Save it. Live. Knife juggler.
It is a little weaker against Ghoul, but I mean.
Yeah, if it doesn't hit, like. Ooh.
I really like just. Now Ghoul is already really good.
Yeah.
And Ghoul would be really weak if you hit the 50-50 because then the knife juggler stays on board.
Yeah, and you still go for the Ghoul in here, so...
I mean, sure, you have to kill the knife juggler first, trade in, because otherwise the villager spawns a knife, which could kill your dragon. So yeah, you definitely trade in the flame juggler, and the knife juggler before you play Ghoul.
Yeah, sure. So, here we go. But his hand, he's lacking a 4-drop.
Yeah, but AK1 is lacking a 3-drop.
Yeah.
We probably just Direwolf double trade.
Yeah, sure. And, yeah. Let's see what he draws. Maybe, like...
Just a 3-6 turn would be pretty good here.
Oh.
That's weak.
Oh, okay. It's just hero power.
So.
And on the other hand,
you want to go for more minions because there's no real AoE in the Dragon Warrior. So you'd prefer to go double 2-drop, but since you don't have that, you just go for the for the Dark Iron. There's like basically no alternative.
Yeah.
Knife Tractor Tap seems too slow.
Yeah, especially with the Doom Guard in your hand.
Yeah. This is a 4-4 challenge, it's a 5-4 next turn, you kinda expect a turn 5.
Yeah, especially because you haven't seen a 4-drop, so...
I
wield the
power of black. I mean, not seeing a 4-drop would also mean that he doesn't have a Terrain, so he didn't want to play the 2-6. But in most cases against Zoo, you would still play the 2-6.
Yeah, sure, yeah. Especially because your alternative was just armor up.
Pretty sure you play Knife Juggler, like you trade Knife Juggler Forbidden Ritual, you saw a ghoul already and you want to get empty your hand for Doomguard on turn 7 probably.
Yeah.
You play Argus and whatever you draw on turn 6 and whatever you draw on turn 7 plus Doomguard then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think... What's the alternative? Just alternative trade in
playing Knife Juggler Forbidden Ritual and go face with a 4-4.
Or you just trade and play a Forbidden Ritual into Knife Juggler Defender.
Oh, actually, yeah, maybe.
That's better, I guess.
But that's...
That's
even
more
weaker
risky.
To the ghoul, but I guess that might be better.
Yeah, I think it's better.
But in the end, until turn 7, you probably still have stuff to play because you draw a card next turn, so you don't have to play. But it's decent, yeah.
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah, it's probably correct.
Just a little bit of face damage, it's not worth it. Okay, here we go. Oh, Onyxia?
So, I mean, there's no alternative to the Dragon Knight Crusher here.
It's kind of odd because he kind of skipped his mid game.
Yeah, like, his at hand least wasn't very good. Like, getting Grom and double Dragon Knight Crusher early on isn't what you want, and no Onyxia. There's no way we see any trades here.
Okay.
Like, the only trades we would see was just Saiyan's face.
Which aren't trades.
It's 2016, you don't trade in Hassan anymore.
Especially because you have these strange shields around your minions.
Yeah. Yeah, like, by playing taunts when you trade, like...
Yeah.
No point in it.
Or creeper face.
What? That didn't go hit the face.
Yeah, you're right. That did. Why didn't it hit the face?
Misclick? Two misclicks?
Two misclicks in a row?
I mean, has to be. You saw no ghoul last turn, I guess. 100% you would have had the ghoul if you had it. I think.
Oh, kinda punished, or? With the top deck C-joint?
So
yeah,
just
no.
Flame him, C-joint, double trade, next turn Doomguard. But yeah, he could have tapped if he didn't trade.
Yeah.
Elsa, he would have traded his 1-1 instead of the Argus, and afterwards he has a level 2-3. No, wait, he has to trade everything in anyway to kill it, but still. Elsa missed 2 damage.
And missed face.
Yeah,
missed which is more
face.
Important.
Yeah, he lost 1 card and 2 damage to face by trading. Obviously, he plays 1 ghoul, but it's only be a top deck ghoul. So if you need, what's like Direwolf? Oh, I guess that could, no, there's not really any one drop that makes you kill the Grom. No, you sadly can't Mortal Coil, so I guess you just abuse the Sergeant.
Yeah.
Go face for 15.
So he's
I
thinking about
yeah,
Possessed Religion.
There's no trade, there's no way you trade into the Grom. Yeah, you just abuse the Grom. Hit face for 15 damage.
Taking, proactive play here. There you go. Positioning for the second defender, maybe.
Any, if any of your minions survives, you have Lisa. So. Positioning dense game. So you can Quark and execute one of them, trade Quark into one of the big ones, so Quark would be at a 10-1. You armor ups, you are 1 out of range.
And then you die to, a lot of cards.
I mean, a lot of buffs are already used.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, it's obvious. Oh, he doesn't go for it. It's going. Does he have an out? I don't know. I think he could have gone for it. Obviously, he would most likely be dead, and even if he is not, he would still be behind. But still has a trend run Gorm after trading with Doom. Like, you Croc one into the Sea Giant, execute it, trade your Gorm into the 5-7 Doom Guard, then face tank one of the minions' hero power. If your opponent doesn't top deck damage, you would have to trade his 2-1 into your Gorm probably, and then you might stabilize. Obviously, it is if, and it's not a great chance, but
maybe it's your
I think it's better than better chance than Azor Drake.
Yeah. But so it's 2 each, and
with Azor Drake, you couldn't even the 3-6 taunt would not be an out, I don't think, because then you can't hero power, you don't have mana left, so it would still be just. I guess you have to trade the Sea Giant then, instead of the Doom Guard. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like.
Okay, but here we go. Last match of the day, so. And we have.
It's not the last match of the day because we would still see the deciders match between.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, of course. Yeah, sure. I'm sorry, yeah.
Purple.
So, but for one of those guys, it's the last match of the day, I guess, then.
The last match of the tournament, even.
Oh, yeah.
And I think Stuart is favored on this spot, like heavily favored.
I'm not sure about heavily.
Yeah, like look at his hand. His hand works out against AK Wonder's hand.
Yeah, now with this hand, yeah, okay. I didn't saw the hand until now, yeah.
I mean, the matchup itself isn't favored for Kasun Druid.
Yeah, I just was wondering because you said like highly favored. I was like,
I said at this point.
So, and now you're in a bad spot because no matter what you play, it's dead. Like, in like the next 3 turns, not days. Yeah.
Like, he needs a top deck and Imgang was next turn, I think, to have a chance. Just coin the... Oh, he doesn't... I would have coined the 2-1.
Mm-hmm. Because it's your opponent shows you that he is, like, in a really bad spot, but maybe...
Yeah, this is fine, this is decent. Yeah. It's a little awkward against Imgang was, but since he drew the... Since he got the Feral Rage of Raven Idol, he even has an answer to it.
Yeah. And the other play would be awkward against Imgang boss anyhow.
Yeah, but you can go for the tempo then, right? Like, then you would trade your 3-4, because it's your...
Still awkward.
Minion wouldn't be damaged, so you trade your 3-4 into the Imgang boss. He will power awkward. It down, Living Woods for 2-1-1s, go face for 2 damage, he trades into your 2-1 and your... No, yeah. I guess you'd have to Living Woods down a 1-1 then. Yeah, never mind.
Still awkward.
Yeah. Maybe his play was just better. But if he didn't get Feral Rage, he would be really awkward to Imgang boss anyway.
Same level of awkward.
And if he gets Feral Rage, he could still go Raven Idol, coin Feral Rage next turn.
Oh, life tap turn 3. It's probably.
Yeah. Can we call the game off at this point? Like,
it hurts. It just hurts.
I would take like 9 to 1 bets on Druid winning here. Easily.
Yeah. Every time you life tap in the first 4 turns, somewhere a warlock dies. And most of the times it's just you.
Yeah, I mean, unless you're a Renolock, but if you're a Renolock, you don't plan on winning anyway, so I guess.
Yeah, okay.
You're super far behind on board, obviously, and your hand isn't even good.
No.
So, like, he has like knife strike, like double one drop. And can get some lucky snipes and come back. Like, even for this scenario, his hand is bad.
Yeah, but that's probably the best chance you have. And it's really gross because he was 2-0 behind. Then he manages to catch up. And then he gets like this.
Yeah, he wins like the bad matchups. And then like loses a good one. Like, he was really far behind having Wazoo with bad matchups left. Winning the 2 bad matchups just to lose a good matchup in the end.
Feels bad.
Good, yeah. For sure, trade. Double trade in the 1-1.
Yeah, sure.
To basically force out the Doomguard now, because if Fentrill stays on board for more than one turn, the game is pretty over.
Yeah. Especially Feral Rage from the Raven Idol.
I mean, Feral Rage isn't even that good.
It's not that good, yeah.
You'd rather have, like, Nourish. No, it's just pretty good.
Yeah, I'll wait for the top deck. Wait for the top deck.
Even just a swipe.
Okay, so you can play Kasun.
Yeah, like Azor Drake, just early. To set up for Kasun on turn 6.
No, oh, seven. Never mind. Raven Idol, here we go.
Wait. Oh, yeah, his Fentanyl out. So they want to get an innervate so you can cast through next turn. Oh, that's an innervate. His options are Mulch, Innervate, Starfall. I'm pretty sure we'll see the Innervate here.
Yeah, here we go.
His Kassoon is buffed by a lot because the 3-1 got a couple of ticks and anti-baited the Skyfall. So next turn, a 13-13 Kassoon. Like even Sea Giant doesn't save you from a 13-13.
We'll see, yeah. So he can play a lot of creatures, trade one, the big creatures off.
You can put everything off with Direwolf and PO. It's a pale sea giant. So you remove the board, but I guess if Kassoon gets like really unlucky shots, doesn't kill the taunt, it could be awkward.
Yeah, it could be, but still you got.
But getting 30 missiles and a 13-13 on board is pretty good. But yeah, I mean, I guess there's a chance, just not very high.
Yeah. Therefore, that he tapped turn 3, he's in pretty good shape.
Yeah, this turn is really good for him, but.
Yeah.
From his perspective, he's like ahead now because he has a sea giant, he has. A good board, his opponent has 5 cards on hand, 6 mana. Like, you don't really expect the innervate Kassoon after you already saw the 1 innervate, like it's the 3rd innervate.
Yeah, 3 innervates, it's pretty broken, I guess.
So, yeah, AK Wanda's probably thinking he is in a very favored spot at this point. Especially since it's Kassoon true, it's probably no Mulch in the deck.
Yeah, and especially because he was so far behind. Like, so far behind.
It's pretty heartbreaking for AK Wanda.
So, okay. Will. Okay.
If he kills the taunt, that's good, yeah. Actually, it's really good to not waste more damage on the sea giant because you don't kill it anyway, so getting that much damage on face was insane. But Argus is pretty good.
Yeah, Argus is pretty good. So you can also draw cards if you want to.
No, you want to buff the small minions so your sea giant can't get traded in. So you're abusive. Crazed Alchemist on, I think it's 13-13, but you might do it on the Abusive to play around Living Roots?
Living Roots, yeah.
Or maybe Rest for Wand, Hero
yeah,
Power.
But then it's still Living Roots, Hero Power, or Rest for 3, so you can't really play around it.
I mean, it's still better, not giving him a card draw. I think the 2-3 is better, because you never kill the 13-13. Like, you want to kill the opponent's face, right? Actually, you might kill it.
Yeah, but the face, it's 30.
Yeah, so
it's
maybe...
It's not even red.
Yeah, so maybe you have to keep it as a 3-2, so Kassoon might take one more damage for you to kill it. In that case, you would just use Crazed Alchemist on either the Argus or the... Oh wait, no. I don't like this. I thought we'd trade this more. I guess if our plan is to kill Kassoon... Oh yeah, use on the Sea Giant. No.
No.
That doesn't do much because the extra HP won't make a difference. I mean, it's 8 attack anyway, doesn't matter if it is 7 or 11.
Yeah, and now you can't really kill off Platoon in any scenario, right? Oh, there's the Ras for 2.
That's what we said. We said
Ooh, predicted it. Again.
Sick.
Sick. Sick
so
course.
You tap and concede.
Yeah, so AK Wanders is out.
Yeah, I think that the first match of the group was AK Wanda against Purple, so just saying against Purple won't be a rematch. They're pretty interesting series, like every player winning the unfavored matchups, but losing the good matchups.
Pretty sick. And he had almost a comeback from here.
Yeah.
Which was quite insane, because...
AK Wanda probably thought he had that game when he played the Sea Giant. Like, the second... Innervate, the third Innervate, and Kassoon. That's not what you expect on turn 6.
Yeah, it was like 95% lose against, into win, into, yeah, lose again.
Yeah.
Into that phase.
That's not a nice way to lose.
No. Especially not if you drop out of the tournament.
Yeah, and it was a elimination match.
Okay.
So, we will go into a break. The next match will be Just Saiyan against Purple. Two of the probably, I guess both of them are maybe top 5 in America.
Mm-hmm.
Like, 2 of America's finest. So, stay around for that.
More and Shaman action coming soon. More big minions with Taunt and Death Rattle.
Unless they ban Shaman.
Yeah, unless they ban Shaman.
We'll see.